Hello, I'm Shannon with Structure in Seconds. In a sagittal section like this one, the vagina is seen angled backwards, while the cervix and uterine body bend forwards over the top of the bladder. Not every uterus has the same anatomy. What we see here is the most common configuration. The cervix is angled forward relative to the vagina. This is called anteversion. The uterus is also angled gently forward. This is called anteflexion. So in this person, the uterus is anteflexed and anteverted. Now, with this clay model, let's look at some of the other possible combinations of these two angles. In some patients, the uterus is tipped posteriorly toward the rectum. This is called retroflexion. So a patient with this anatomy would be anteverted but retroflexed. The cervix of the uterus may also bend backwards. This is called retroversion. As I bend the clay back, I'm now modeling a uterus that is retroflexed and retroverted. It's also possible to have an anteflexed but retroverted uterus. All of these are normal anatomical variants, but if any of the angles is too extreme, the uterus can push on adjacent organs. Too much anteflexion of an anteverted uterus can lead to urinary problems. Just as too much retroflexion in a retroverted uterus can lead to defecation problems.